I'm sorry, I couldn't remember your name.
Krupali.
Krupali, yeah, I got it. Thank you. My name is Govind Raj.
Yeah. Yeah. How are you?
Oh, very fine. Thank you. And how about you?
I'm good. I'm really good. What do you do?
Have you ever wondered what it is like for a visually challenged person to have a conversation with you? Does he or she understand what a face looks like?
Yeah, I'm a telephone operator in Sankara.
Does he give your voice a face? What does he or she imagine you to be like? Very much like you trying to put a face to a voice of a radio jockey? Only in this case, chances are he or she might have no idea what a face is, especially if he or she was born without vision. And one simple act of yours could help him or her to possibly see what you look like.
I have to go to movies.
Yeah, I do watch movies.
Vatsala was born blind. After 10 years of living in the dark, today she can see. Pachapa turned blind due to an accident. Today he can see. Venkatamal turned blind due to infections. Today she can see. And they have one thing to thank. Someone out there had donated their eyes.
Eye donation is perhaps the most humanitarian cause one could think of. It is donating an individual's eyes after his or her demise to someone who is blind. We all think in terms of a memorial for a person. You want to remember somebody, we just create a statue here and there. But that is not the right kind of commemorating the memory. If out of those two eyes of the departed person, if we can make a child see this world or an adult get back to his work and become a breadwinner, then what happens? He or she is the real memorial or the commemorative piece as far as the departed person is concerned.
To understand blindness, one needs to understand the functioning of the eye. When light enters the eye, it passes through the cornea, where two-thirds of the focus is achieved. The light then passes through the pupil, where the iris adjusts the amount of light that is allowed to enter. The remaining one-third of the focus is then achieved when light passes through the lens. The focused light finally reaches the retina, where it is converted by the rods and cones into a signal that can travel to the brain. Once the image reaches the brain, you have sight. And a damage to any of the parts of the eye can result in total or partial blindness.
In the cataract is the commonest cause of blindness. After cataract, the commonest cause of blindness is diabetic retinopathy and corneal blindness. Diabetic retinopathy, you can do lasers and surgery and restore. Whereas in corneal blindness, we need a donor cornea. Without a donor cornea, we cannot restore the vision in that particular patient.
A human eye is one of its kind. It can survive even after death if it is preserved under lab conditions. In case of a transplant, only the cornea is transplanted. Corneal transplant is an operation that replaces the opaque cornea of the diseased eye with the clear cornea obtained from a human donor, thus enabling the restoration of vision in the recipient.
All the corneal donations happens after the death, whereas the other organs are harvested before actually the heart stops.
But how exactly does the corneal blindness occur? In most cases, it is genetic. Sometimes it could be acquired through infections, and in others, it could be due to an accident. But then the result is the same. It is a dark world for all those suffering from it.
A child who is corneally blind, you're looking at next 80, 85 years of productive life ahead of the child. Child doesn't know what's going to happen. child is handicapped. Whether it is education, there is no equality for that child at all. If it is a middle-aged person who is blind, he cannot be a breadwinner of the family anymore unless he gets, he is desperate. He has to get back his vision. Similarly, an elderly person also could be corneally blind. And he is always dependent because of his blindness. Even for his routine day-to-day work, he has to depend on somebody to take him here and there. And believe me, right from a child to an adult to an elderly person, those who are corneally blind, life is absolutely dark.
Blindness is one of the hindrances for the growth of our country. 1/4 of the world's blind population lives in India. 12 million are totally blind, and this number is increasing. Out of these, nearly 80% are either curable or needlessly blind. But these are mere statistics. What is important is realizing the fact that in most cases, the blindness can be reversed through eye donation. But the very concept of eye donation is surrounded by myths and fears, and in some cases, the law itself.
In developed countries like in US or in Europe, most of the European countries, the person, once he decides to donate the organs, he will give his consent. It will be written in his driving license, the card which he carries in his pocket always. So once he dies, they can just take the organs. Whereas in India, it is not like that. Even a donor, a person carries that he is willing to, he is given his consent to donate the organs, unless the body belongs to their children or to the parents. So unless they give consent, you cannot take the organs out of the body. So that makes the availability of the human tissue very little in India.
First thing, they think, eye donation, will it be disfiguring? That the first doubt, everything, for everyone, that the first doubt comes in their mind. Are they going to remove the eye of my grandfather and leave a hole there? The whole body looks disfigured. Certainly not. Eye donation is certainly not disfiguring. We respect somebody who has passed away. We would not like to go and disfigure the body. When we remove the eyes, we put an artificial eye which looks far more beautiful than the natural eye.
What I find is many people have this notion in their mind saying that if we were to give away those eyes, the person being born again will be without eyes. This is why I said, you know, this is one thing which is occurring to people's mind. And so, if our leaders, spiritual leaders, were to spread this word around, saying that no such thing is going to happen, I assure you that the donations will multiply.
Sometimes the donors might be willing, but the relatives might not find it that important.
Similarly, there are quite a few doubts. When the eye to be removed, who can donate? I've been hypertensive, I've been a diabetic patient, can I donate my eyes? I've been wearing glasses, can I donate my eyes? So these misconceptions have to be cleared to say that who can donate, how to donate, and when to donate.
The eyes of a child or that of the elderly can be used to restore vision. There is no age limit when it comes to the concept of eye donation. What is important is that the eye has to be removed within 6 hours after the death. Please remember the following steps after calling the nearest eye bank. Close the eyes of the deceased and cover it with a moist cotton. Switch off any ceiling fan that is directly overhead. Place a pillow to raise the head of the deceased by about 6 inches. These simple but effective steps will help preserve the health of the cornea.
Today, there is an urgent requirement for corneas. For every 100 persons in need of a graft, only 10 corneas are available.
There has to be more thrust in the whole approach. Only few organizations here and there coming and talking about eye donation would definitely reach a certain amount of the cross-section of the society. But you want to reach to the mass as well, the media should come in a very big way.
Things have changed in the last few years. The awareness has spread to smaller towns and villages. Regular camps have helped give sight to many who had given up hope of ever seeing light. And with celebrities coming forward to donate their eyes, there is a wider understanding of the issue. But the question is this enough? Do the other society stakeholders need to do more?
I believe any corporation, you know, has an obligation to society. You know, that is one. You know, they have an obligation. Second, any corporation, profitable corporation in general, is a very efficient organism, to so to speak. It's a very efficient entity. If it sets mind to do it, you know, it can really make a difference. Unlike, say, for example, if we talk about government. Government, again, fundamentally because of the way it is structured, efficiency is not there. Whereas an organization like us, you know, a profitable organization, is very efficient in what it sets to do. It can convert vision into goals, into actual results. So because it is a capable organization, it is structured and wired to do something, it is all it needs is take up a vision, take up a cause, and then execute on it.
And then there is another segment of society that can definitely make a difference. The generation next.
There is a big difference between pledging your eyes and eye donation. By merely signing a pledge, it is not going to translate into a person getting vision. Become a catalyst for change and motivate the family of the bereaved to donate their eyes. That is what is going to restore the vision to millions across India.
It is time to pause for a moment and ponder over the differences we can make. Appreciate the fact that we, as normal human beings, are blessed. Each of us could help two people experience the world after we die. If only we could raise a hand to support the cause of eradicating preventable blindness, the rewards could be soul-stirring.
இப்போ எனக்கு ரெண்டு விஷயமே நல்லா இருக்கு.
சர்ஜரிக்கு அப்புறம் தான் நான் 12th ஸ்டாண்டர்ட் பப்ளிக் எக்ஸாம் அட்டெண்ட் பண்ணேன். அதுல நான் வந்து 1081 வாங்கினேன். 1200 அவுட் ஆஃப்
தேர் வாஸ் அ டோட்டலி பிளைண்ட் சைல்ட், 2 இயர் ஓல்ட் சைல்ட் பை நேம் மைக்கேல். ஒன்லி ஒன் ஐ could be saved. பட் ஆஃப்டர் த டிரான்ஸ்பிளான்ட், தேர்ட் டே ஆஃப்டர் த பேண்டேஜ் வாஸ் ரிமூவ்ட், த சைல்ட் வாஸ் இன்சைட் த ரூம். வி ஸ்லோலி ஓபன்ட் த டோர் டு see what this kid is doing. பிலீவ் மீ, he was keeping his hand in front of his operated eye and the child was moving it up and down. The child was seeing light and movement for the first time in his life. Could you imagine what would have been our feeling at that time? Millions cannot give you that satisfaction.
For every Vatsala, for every Pachappa, for every Venkatamal, there are 100 more who can lead a normal life. There is a dream that is lurking behind those eyes. A dream of seeing all the wonderful things nature has created. A dream to look at the world around them. A dream to be normal. A dream to be like you and me. Today, we can make a choice. We can make that dream come true. We have the power. It just needs a will. A will to want to turn darkness to light. Support eye donation. Begin with your pledge. Make a difference. Don't burn. Don't bury. Donate your eyes.